to God, all things are possible. Welcome, my beautiful brothers and sisters, connecting from all over Mother Earth this magnificent day. The feast of Saint Rita of Cascia. As we connect to the portal of the Casa de Dom Ignacio, the house of love, where the medicine is love, here in Abajania, in the heart of Brazil. And we have another glorious day sent by God, this gift of life that we have been given to walk the path of the light. There's many clouds today passing by, reminding us that we are just travellers on earth and the change is constant. We have a deep blue sky beyond the clouds, reminding us of the comfort and the protection of our Divine Mother Mary in this her month of May. And of course, butterflies everywhere, reminding us of our transformation, birds of paradise singing to us night and day in a divine symphony. And there's so many beautiful flowers in the valley, different colours, different fragrances, and creation is so alive as we embrace this beautiful gift of life. And as we settle deeper and deeper into this divine work, try to be as comfortable as you possibly can. If you're lying on a crystal bed, just relax. If you have calcite crystals, this is beautiful also. And if you prefer to sit upright with your heads elevated just a little, so this energy can flow fluidly, freely and easily through each and every one of us, like a river. A current of love and light. Don't block your body in any way. And if you can remember, put a glass of water beside you and we ask the spirits to come and energize the water. And at the end of the work, we can drink this to nourish our mind, body and spirit. And to fortify us in these challenging times on earth. Let's put our intention into doing the best work we possibly can. The work of the heart. This is our mission on earth. And many of us are limited in going outside. So let's go within and do this deep, deep inner work, this transformation of our mind, body, and spirit. And as we close our physical eyes, we open our spiritual eyes, where we can see beyond appearances. All there is, as we connect with our true home beyond the veil. We are reminded again and again and again that we're not the body, we're so much more. The body merely houses our eternal spirits. We move in and out of perishable bodies. And we have so many entities helping us along this enduring path. And today, the 22nd of May, we honour our beautiful sister, Saint Rita of Cascia. She was the one who appeared to me. medium Joao on a cloud. When he was just 8 years old, instructing him of his mission. She is so beautiful and so compassionate. She's the most admired saint in the Christian world. And she had a very, very difficult life. She was an only child, wife, mother, widow, nun, and miracle worker. She lived for 40 years in the Saint Mary Magdalene Convent in Cascia, in Italy. Her birth was prophesied. The Margherita, who will shine and who will surpass lands, seas, and humility, will overcome vanity and help the world. Margherita was born to aging parents in 1381 in Rocca Porlena, 5 kilometres from Cascia. As a baby, white bees were coming in out of her mouth, depositing honey on her lips. An injured labourer with a bleeding arm was shooing the bees away, and his arm was miraculously healed. The first of many, many miracles. And Rita was 12 when she told her parents she wanted to be a nun. They told her that she needed to get married for protection, and she, of course, obeyed her parents. At 18, she married a very rough man who abused her, and she had twins. She suffered a lot in her early married years. Her husband was murdered, and she prayed that rather than her sons avenge his death with the vendetta, which was very prevalent in Italy at the time, she asked God to take her sons to heaven. They died from the plague, and she was left alone. She forgave everyone, her husband's murderers and God. She joined the convent and was treated harshly, not because she was a widow, but because of the vendetta, and they were afraid she would cause problems in the convent. She tended humbly a dead vine, and roses bloomed. At 61 years of age, she received the stigmata and bore it for 15 years in abject pain, and an unpleasant odour emanated from it, causing the nuns to avoid her. She was bedridden for 4 years and bore her suffering joyfully, an essential component of Christian sanctity. In 1457, a few months before her death, Rita requested a rose and 2 figs from her kitchen garden. The nuns were very sceptical because it was January. They went and found a single red rose and 2 figs in her garden and brought them to her. Once again, Rita, through this miracle, could see her village through the smell of the rose and the flavour of the 2 figs. On the 22nd of May in 1457, at 76 years of age, Rita passed on into heaven. Her stigmata disappeared immediately, and an intense aroma of roses filled the air. And so many miracles happened around her incorrupt body, which remains 600 years later in Cascia, a place of pilgrimage for millions of people. She is known as the Rose of Rocca Porlena. And the rose is a flower with thorns. And the crown of thorns, one of the thorns, she received the stigmata praying in front of the crucifix of her brother Jesus. So with joy in our hearts, we honor Saint Rita and are so grateful for her presence in our lives. And Jesus, whom she revered and was dedicated to, along with our Divine Mother Mary. Jesus told us many, many centuries ago that when a few are called in his name, he will be present. Trusting the promises of the Christ consciousness, may Christ return to earth. And Jesus gave us all a beautiful gift, bestowing upon his 12 apostles at the Last Supper the very high vibration of the Lord's Prayer that has come down to us through the ages, teaching us how to pray, how to talk to God, our Father, how to surrender to the will of God, how to bring heaven to earth, how to have gratitude for the gifts of life that we have been given, how to forgive ourselves and our brothers and sisters as we receive protection from the darker forces and we honour all of creation eternally. Let us pray trustingly, without ceasing, with open hearts, joyfully, happily. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come. Thy will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation. Rather, deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, the power, and the glory, now and forever. Amen. And to our Divine Mother Mary, the Mother's heart, the feminine power, whom Saint Rita lived fully through her femininity, and she was so dedicated to the Divine Mother of Jesus. We ask Mary in this very moment to intercede for us, our children, to somehow alleviate the suffering of humanity, helping us to keep our hearts open as we find the peace, the harmony, the tranquility, the love, the forgiveness, the compassion, the gratitude, the humility deep, deep within us. And it is within all of us. We are divine beings on our healing journey back home into the celestial fields. Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou among women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus. Holy Mary, Mother of God, pray for us children, now and at the hour of our passing. Amen. illness manifests in our bodies, mental, physical, emotional, spiritual, it is a wake-up call, an opportunity for growth. In these difficult days, we are experiencing growing pains. There's no part of the human condition that doesn't involve some kind of suffering. The wounds are where the light gets in. The light of Jesus pours into the wound of Saint Rita, nourishing her and giving her strength to battle on in difficult days. When we suffer, we turn to God Almighty. Finally, we ask for help. We pray. God did not bring us this far to abandon us. God never abandons us. His children is always listening to us and answering our prayers, giving us what we need. What we think we need and what we actually need are usually two entirely different things. Some of our greatest blessings are unanswered prayers. We just do not realize it at the time. We need to surrender as much as we can to the will of God. Thy will be done, not my will. We have a picture in our limited minds as to how things should be. But there is a bigger picture. This too will pass. We are equipped with everything we need and more to fight this battle on earth. Prayer is a weapon in this fight between the good and the darker forces. The light will always win, triumph. The light of God. And each one of us has a spark of that within us. We already ignited on our paths. We are the ones we have been waiting for. We are the warriors of the light. We have so much help from the other side. Let us multiply this beautiful God light on earth. In this moment, the ninth day of the novena of Saint Rita, let us ask our beautiful sister to help us on our healing journey back home into the light, out of separation, into oneness, one heart, one soul, one light, one love. Holy patroness of those in need, dear Saint Rita, whose pleadings before our Divine Lord are favourably received, who has been called the advocate of the hopeless and impossible cases. Be generous, dear Saint Rita, to your supplicants and show your power with God on our behalf. Be lavish to us now in your favours, as you have been in so many wonderful cases, for the greater glory of God, the spreading of your devotion, and the consolation for those who trust in you. Relying on your power of intercession before the Sacred Heart of Jesus, dear Saint Rita, we ask you now in this sacred moment to increase our faith. May we fix our gaze on the light of God. Help us to forgive everything, to count our blessings, to realize nothing is impossible to God. Hear our supplications, dry our tears, and answer our prayers. Blessed be. Amen. there is a holy shift happening on Mother Earth right now. This explosion of consciousness on the planet is our opportunity to grow, to shift into a new dimension of love and light. We need to stay elevated and remember, not everybody is awakened. We need to be very gentle with each other. We're just walking each other home into the light. And we're never given anything we cannot handle. We were born for these times. We've gone back to school. This is the school of life. And a lesson will be repeated again and again until it is learned. We're learning patience, for sure. We are learning to become better mediums, better channels of this beautiful divine light. To expand it, to grow it, and to multiply it. So needed now, in these darker days. We are greatly held in the love of God. And this too will pass. Everything does. Change is constant. We're learning to reach out and ask for help when we need it. And we have so much help available from the other side of the veil. Never forget, nothing is impossible when we ask Saint Rita. We're learning to surrender more and more to the divine will of God. There's God's plan and there's our plan. God's plan works and ours doesn't. But most of all, we're learning to open our hearts, which is our mission on Earth. To be kind. We're learning to love ourselves. Not easy. To love our brothers and sisters. How hard is that? What you see in others exists in you. And we're all brothers and sisters right across the globe. We're learning to forgive ourselves, to stop beating ourselves up. We're doing the best we can. And to forgive our brothers and sisters. In the memory of Saint Rita forgiving her husband's murderers and forgiving God for taking her sons to heaven. Can't imagine how much love that takes. We're not perfect beings yet, we're working on it. We're getting to know God, who is all loving, all compassionate, all forgiving, with us every step of this journey. Knowing God is much more important than knowing about God. And Saint Rita was helped into the convent in Cascia by Saint Augustine. She was transported miraculously through the walls. So many miracles with Saint Rita. And she lived by the Augustine rule, to serve God with fast and prayers, with charity in total service to God. We have a lot to learn from these great saints. And through the intercession of Saint Rita, let us absorb these beautiful words from Saint Augustine, helping us in our search for God. When I seek my God, I seek not corporal grace, nor transient beauty, nor splendor, nor melodious sound, nor sweet fragrance of flowers, nor odious essence, nor honeyed manna, nor grace of any form, or anything pleasing of the flesh. None of these things do I seek when I seek my God. When I seek my God, I seek a light exceeding all light, which the eyes cannot see, a voice sweeter than all sound, which the ear cannot hear, a sweetness above all sweetness, which the tongue cannot taste, a fragrance above all fragrance, which the senses cannot perceive, a mysterious and divine embrace, which the body cannot feel. For this light shines without radiance, this voice is heard without striking the air, this fragrance is perceived though the wind does not bear it, this taste inebriates with no palate to relish it, and this embrace is felt in the center of the soul. Amen. Thank you. sacred moment now. Let us relax a little bit. Take a deep, deep breath. As we are open to receive. In the name of Saint Rita of Cascia, a deep, deep, deep cleansing. As we surrender all of our problems, our anxieties, our fears, our pain, our hurt, our anger, our grudges, our resentment, our lack of gratitude, our lack of forgiveness, all of our issues over to our Creator, the Architect of the Cosmos, transmuting all of this denser energy into divine light as we become lighter, happier, healthier, stronger, more peace and harmony with all of creation, of which each and every one of us is an integral part of. If you'd like to visualize a waterfall, like the waterfall here at the Kaz or any place of sacred running water that you know with all the gifts of Mother Nature. Big blue butterflies helping us with our transformation, strong green oak trees cleansing our oxygen, carpets of magnificent, colourful, fragrant flowers, and roses red with the smell of Saint Rita of Cascia. Brilliant sunshine, birds of paradise serenading us in a divine symphony, and crystal clear waters embodying rainbows of light. Let's all go to this beautiful place together. Bring your families and friends with you, and bring those you need to forgive, and those who need to forgive you. There has never been a better time to let go of anything and everything that no longer serves us. Anything that's not from the light, transmuting all of this denser energy. Brother Medium Shuao into this high vibration, and anyone and everyone who has been affected or is affected with the problems at the Casa. And not forgetting our brothers and sisters without their physical bodies who need to be liberated into the light, extending this beautiful cleansing healing energy to them also. Every being deserves to be healed, whether we have a body or not. As we receive this glorious love light from on high pouring into our open hearts, let's share it with the world, allowing it to gush forth into all hospitals, helping our angel doctors and nurses, all our healthcare professionals, and anyone and everyone who is in a caring capacity now in these difficult days. Allowing this God light to pour into nursing homes, helping our elders, into hospices, orphanages, prisons, asylums, anywhere and everywhere on planet Earth where our brothers and sisters are suffering or in pain or are hungry. Allowing this beautiful high vibration to gush forth into the war zones, bringing peace and harmony in our lifetime. Saint Rita will tell us, to God, all things are possible. Pouring into the migrant camps, helping to liberate our brothers and sisters. We're all God's children. Allowing this magnificent high vibration to gush forth into the consciousness of our government leaders. We need them now more than ever to make good decisions about our future and the future for our children and all future generations to come. To put people before profit. Every being matters. Permitting this crystal clear, pristine energy to gush forth into our ecosystems, regenerating, nourishing, cleansing and healing. Already, Mother Nature is recovering. Hallelujah, praise God. This gorgeous love light enveloping Gaia in this moment, cleansing and healing as it grows and multiplies and expands, helping all beings, carnate and disincarnate, as it pours into infinity. and in this solemn hour when our hearts are filled with God's love, nourishing us, protecting us, helping us in these pivotal times on earth. Thank you, God Almighty, for another day to learn these lessons, to evolve, to grow in love and light together as one heart, bringing us closer to our liberation. And thank you to these magnificent entities of light and love with us every step of this journey. On this tiny, tiny planet we call home for now, and who are beautiful Saint Rita of Cascia, reminding us that nothing is impossible to God. And may we be blessed with the aroma of your roses, comforting us, guiding us, helping us. Thank you. And as always, to our brother Jesus and Mary, our Divine Mother, who are with us forever, we are in such gratitude for this opportunity to be in love and service. And to all of you, my warrior, beautiful brothers and sisters from all over Mother Earth, for your dedication, your commitment, your courage, your faith, your hope, your compassion, your kindness, your light, and your love. To be in service. Your faith will heal you, and your love and your light are changing the world forever for the better. Thank you. Not afraid of love, for it alone can heal all sorrow. Fail not in your function of loving in a loveless place made out of darkness and deceit, for thus are darkness and deceit undone. The holiest of all the spots on earth is where an ancient hatred has become a present love, in the spirit of Saint Rita's forgiveness. Love cannot be far behind a grateful heart and a thankful mind. There is no room in us for fear today, for we have welcomed love into our hearts. We are deceived no longer. Love has now returned to our awareness, and we are at peace again, for fear has gone and only love remains. Love holds no guidances. When we let all of our grievances go, we will know that we are perfectly safe in the arms of God. Love, loving, love. Namaste.